welcome to Tea Time today with me, Chaiti Narula. It's a lovely sunny afternoon right here at JP Greens in Greater Noida, and we are at the Take World Corporate Golf Challenge. And joining me today is a young and dynamic CEO. He's an avid golfer, he is passionate about technology, and when he talks, he makes a difference.
On the show this week, we have Shubhadeep Pal, CMO Micromax.
I've heard consumers say, why do you want to spend $31,000 when you can get the same thing at $39.90? I think today consumers are becoming smart.
In news, Shamim Khan and Rashid Khan helped Silver Glades Delhi to lift the 1.2 crore rupees Louis Philippe Golf Cup. And John Murick wins Northern Trust Open first career PGA Tour title.
Soaring sky high is your tee off. Shubhadeep, welcome to the show today with me. Lovely to have you here. How was the day today at the tournament?
Very good. In fact, it was great weather. Delhi can't be as good as what it can be during winter, especially for golf. It's been a great round so far, and you've pulled me out for lunch, but I'm happy to spend this time with you.
Okay, tell me, how long have you been in this career? You are so passionate about technology.
It's been a good 16 odd years. I started my career with Samsung way back in 1996. Spent about a year after that with ABN AMRO to take a break from the consumer durable industry. And then, as usual, the way I am, I'm still so passionate about technology. So I saw an opportunity in HP, so became the consumer marketing head at HP for about 4.5 years, and then moved on to a very different set of technology people, especially in the mobile advertising world with Blick. And then Micromax happened. It's been a very technological merry-go-round for me. I love technology.
What is it about technology that drives you so much?
I don't know. The sheer fun, the sheer joy of seeing things coming alive, the sheer consumer delight you see in people, as a consumer and as you see for consumer themselves. I just don't know. It's just there in my blood.
We're gonna discuss a little more about that after I tee off. A cyber media research report indicates that the tablet shipments has gone very high in the country. The leading the pack, of course, is Micromax as well. Elucidate the reasons why.
Very simple reasons. Micromax is known to make very affordable products.
Right.
When I say affordable, does not necessarily mean cheap. Feature packed, yet has its permutations, combinations, because there's a segment everywhere in the marketplace today. And that's the reason I think they got their act right. We launched way back just about April, not even a year back, and we're a clear number one across the country.
So you are number one, followed by Samsung, followed by Apple.
Yeah.
How are you maintaining this market position, and how far do you think you're going to be able to sustain this, because the competitive advantage that your peers are coming with is very strong?
Well, Micromax is known for technological innovations, so I'm sure the market will wait for a lot of different products from our stable. And as far as we are concerned, I think the advantage we have is a very strong product lineup, followed by a great distribution which exists in our system. And obviously, our if you look at the new tonality of our advertising, it's completely different. It's meant for a very premium aspiration brand, and it's gone are those days when you could just take things for granted. Today, yes, you're right, absolutely right. We can't just sit back by saying we're number one. We need to continue to charter towards that.
You said new tonality in terms of your advertising. So there's an old Micromax, and there's obviously a new Micromax which you started conceiving about 2 to 3 months ago.
Sure.
What is the new tonality like? Because obviously we know how we perceive the brand, and we continue to perceive the brand now. How are we going to be perceiving a few years down the line, or a few months down the line?
A few years down the line, I'll be very, very, very straight. I want my consumers to be very proud of the brand they own, and they should be proud of picking up the phone and putting it on their table. That's simple as that. The perception in the marketplace today is, yes, it's a very tier 2, tier 3 brand. Again, my definition of tier 2 and tier 3 is very different compared to what other people think. Yes, reality says those are tier 2 and tier 3, but I find a tier 1, tier 2, tier 3 in any marketplace today. And that's how we're looking at our game plan going forward. I mean, look at the tonality of the advertising. If Micromax needs to be a global player, which means, suppose we go out in a very big way to the global markets, then people need to understand our communication there. The tonality has to be right. I just can't think of what's required here in India alone to be a global player.
Now, 60 successful brands from Micromax umbrella. What next?
If you notice our trends since November last year, we're very focused on the tier one markets, the big markets as the, or the metro markets as you call it, simply being that we were quite weak there. I won't say we were quite weak, we were weak in the sense that our retail presence wasn't very strong.
Right.
However, the products were still selling.
Right.
So now we're going to make sure that we're very visible here, which means making sure the retail space is taken up in a very different way. We do what is right, what is best needed for this particular space, and that's where we. And you see a lot of little things we're going to do, especially from the visual merchandising point of view, or whether you're talking about creating some landmark stores for our audiences and things like that. There are phones which are packed with a lot of stuff, but how many features or how many apps do you actually use? But if I start giving you relevant stuff to you, and which is important, and if I can save costs and I can pass that to you, that's where, you know, I feel the joy of giving the right product to the market.
On that note, let's take a quick break right here on Tea Time. We are in conversation with Shubhadeep Pal, who is the CMO of Micromax. We will remain in conversation with him on the other side of this break as well.
We gained number one share in the phablet market, which means the 5-inch screen segment. We beat our competition there hands down.
Welcome back. It's still Tea Time, and we are in conversation with Shubhadeep Pal, who is the CMO of Micromax. Now, we were discussing earlier about your company and strategies. Of course, one very interesting part about your company is that you've had many firsts to your credit. Dual SIM card, 30-day battery pack. All of this is coming at a very affordable price. How are you managing that?
Basic economies of scale, right? We don't have a factory here in India. So we have facilities way back in China, and that's where most of the big corporates also have their stuff there, be it Samsung, be it Apple, be it any of them. So what we're trying to do is to leverage their economies of scale and ensure that, you know, we give them and pass on that benefit to the consumer. Our entire R&D center is at Narayana here in Delhi. That's where we're headquartered as well. So the basic drawing board happens here, and that's when we go back to Foxconn in China, and that's where the production happens. And obviously, with the policies and the trade policy between us and China and things around it, there's a lot of benefits we get, and therefore we just ensure that we pass on those benefits to the consumer.
Okay, so you don't have a production unit in India. You are dependent on contract manufacturing for the supply of handsets. Does that remain a concern for you at Micromax?
Not at the moment, because as of now we're managing logistics, we're managing the BOM costs, which are very, very competitive as such. Going forward, we've got now direct tie-ups with the chipset manufacturers themselves. So I'm not seeing any need of a manufacturing unit which just needs to be run by Micromax. As of now, we're managing everything with third parties, though our people are always stationed there. So it's just a physical unit which is absent. But going forward, if we really think of Micromax really going global, then there could be a need. And that's a call I think the management will take.
When is that going to happen? You have a timeline in place for that?
We're looking at sometime next year. We are already there in a few markets, but again, we're not directly involved there. However, it's through the distribution network and stuff around it. We've got some great response for our products there. Some of the markets are like India. The demographics are the same. Some of them are not. So therefore, the recent launches have actually given us a very, very, very positive response from those markets as well. And going forward, maybe early next year or maybe mid next year.
Apart from Bling, are there any other smartphones directly in competition with the Blackberries and the Apples and the Androids of the world that you're launching in the near future?
The entire Canvas range, which we just launched on the 25th of December 2012.
That was last year.
That was last year. You saw the Canvas 2, which was the phone that can. We just launched the Canvas HD, which is all about colors. It's all about experiences. The colors can come alive. Mm. So you'll see a series of Canvas phones almost every 36 days from now. Canvas 2 was a sellout. We gained number one share in the phablet market, which means the 5-inch screen segment. We beat a competition there hands down. And I've heard consumers say, why do you want to spend 31,000 bucks when you can get the same thing at 39,900? I think today consumers are becoming smart. Gone are the days when somebody used to buy something for life. They want to actually expand and start changing things going forward.
Is there place for new entrants in this market?
Of course. There's India. I think India is a very, very big market. No matter what you produce, as long as you are consistent in quality and you give a great product, no matter what industry you're coming from, I think India is a great market. I mean, there are consumers almost everywhere. Look at restaurants. I mean, today, you find Chinese restaurants dime a dozen, but again,
we have an overproduce of restaurants.
Yeah, we've got an overproduce of restaurants, but again, each of them is as packed as one would be over the weekends. I mean, that's where, I mean,
a lot has to do with growing disposable income as well.
Absolutely. I mean, gone are the days, I mean, where, you know, we had this typical families which were we were binding with each other. The mamas, the chachas, the brothers all stayed together. Now it's becoming absolutely nuclear. People are there, 2-4 people, 3 people. They're moving on with life, fast-paced life. Double incomes have become, or the dual incomes, in fact, have become a fact of life. And they understand that. They also know that once they get that, they have the extra, you know, the money to spend and the purchasing power. And why not live life to the fullest? I mean, it's the quality of life you lead, not the quantity of life.
Well, living life to the fullest is, of course, Shubhadeep Pal of Micromax. He is the CMO. And, of course, he's got an interesting story right there when it comes to his golfing escapades as well. We will touch upon that on the other side of this break. So take a quick break right here on Tea Time. When we return, we've got more with Shubhadeep Pal.
Why the hell are you joining Micromax after such great brands? I said, no, I think I saw a trigger of passion in them, and I have that passion in my gut. So therefore, that's where I think Micromax is. They've done some great work.
Well, not a bad bunker shot at all. Wonderful.
Thank you.
So you're very used to challenges. You've had a hole-in-one as well.
Yes, I did. In fact, 17th of September 2011, DLF hole number 8. Brilliant pitching wedge shot, 135 yards. Dream come true from a golfer's point of view, because goes above the hole, takes a spin, comes back into the hole. Can't ask for more.
Apart from this, what are the other challenges that you have faced on the green before?
Well, some of the courses are challenging simply because of the fact that if you're not used to the course and if you're not used to the greens and the way they're laid out and the speeds, then it does become challenging, because putting is almost like 50% of the game, and that's where the actual challenge begins. You might be 2 on, but again, if you putt within 2, you still make par in a par 4. But however, if your putting is really bad, which means if the caddy is not giving the right line, or you misread the line, you've hit it too fast or too slow. Again, it's a very tactical game. Again, the approach shot which you hit is like, it's like business. You have to think and plan before you start executing it.
You know, a lot of people like you do end up networking a lot on the greens. Has business ever been transacted on a golf course as far as you are concerned?
As far as I'm concerned, yeah. I think my HP job did happen on a business course.
How did that come about? I was
in ABN AMRO then. I was learning golf. Then one of my partners in HP was basically asking me about what I did and what I was doing currently. I talked about ABN, and then he said, weren't you in Samsung? I said, yes, I was. Then he said, I know you moved after 10 and a half years in Samsung, a year in ABN AMRO. I don't think you're going to move again. But however, there's an opportunity for you. Think about it and let us know. And that's when they said, he spoke about HP, and he said, I want the blacks and the gray boxes to be perceived differently for the consumers today, and talk more lifestyle. So would you want to join as head of consumer marketing?
Wow.
And that's where it happened.
And this all happened on a golf course?
Yes, he spoke to me for 15 odd minutes. And then he asked me one last question. He said, do you know it all? I said, no. Life is still... there's a lot of learning to be done in life. However, I'm happy and open to challenges. I know IT is not one of my favorite products, but however, you have this challenge which I love, which is to convert HP from a B2B brand to more of a B2C brand. Mm-hmm. And that's where I took up the challenge and became head of consumer marketing and stayed there for 5 years.
There's no looking back after that.
There's no looking back after that. Actually, I mean, quite lucky that way, I guess. Samsung, it was a nobody in India. I happened to be the right place. 96 just got out of my MBA, and there was. That's it, fine. Give it a shot. Let's see what happens. And I stuck there for such a long time. Learned a lot. Learned the Korean way of working, and then HP the American way of working, the Dutch in between. and now back to the Indians. So
Korea, America, Netherlands,
yeah.
India, you've played golf all over?
Unfortunately, while the Samsung, they were very, very strong in golf, I had no clue about golf because I couldn't get any time for it. But yes, since 2006, July, where I'm sure I'm not going to be back in India on the weekend, and I've played a lot of golf abroad, so I do carry my set.
You do realize that you have a lot of analogy going there with your career and the way you play your golf as well.
Yes, I do. That's the first thing that people ask me, why the hell are you joining Micromax after such great brands? I said, no, I think I saw a trigger of passion in them, and I have that passion in my gut, so therefore that's where I think Micromax is. They've done some great work. I've seen them from the outside. They're now stepping up to the next level, and if I can contribute there and be part of this journey, why not?
In fact, there are quite a couple of interesting golfers today, right here. Did you interact with them? Who do you look up to out of them?
Gaganjit was here. In fact, I was playing with one of the ex-cricketers from India, Nikhil Chopra. Plays some amazing golf. Again, cricket is a game which is a very different team sport, but has a similar swing of a batsman of what a golf is. So if you look at most of the cricketers across the world are one of the most fabulous golfers around. Who I look up to? I used to look up to Tiger Woods a lot. I still do. Yeah. I think he's one of the greatest sportsmen which history has ever created in any sport.
No, we're talking about golfers. Gene Milkha Singh is setting up his academy as well. How good a news is that for golf in the country?
That's great news. Gone are the days when golf was meant to be just a niche sport. But today, if you start looking at, good you raised it, because if you start looking at the different programs the schools are running, different programs the clubs are running, it's unbelievable. Between 4 o'clock and 6 o'clock, you will not find a single place there because there are kids at it. It's just golf, golf, golf for them. And what I love the most is the parents are encouraging that as well.
Yeah.
So the initial start could be there, but after that, once you get onto it, if a child has the rhythm, if a child has the passion or the determination or has that little spark in them, why not hone it? And again, with Jeev doing his fabulous job. He's played some amazing golf. He's been a true brand ambassador as far as India is concerned. You have Shiv Kapoor, you've got Jyoti, you've got Anirban Lahiri. These are some Gaganjit Buldar. Again, creating, despite what we've been through golf in India, they've made some great stuff on their own, with just not much of sponsorship backing, but very little. But today, with the corporates now looking into golf in a very different way, I think.
We're going to talk about the GPL as well, but let's finish our game first. But such is life anyway, missing things by a whisker.
This is again slow green.
We were talking about GPL, Golf Premier League. Good news for the industry, of course, because you spoke about corporate sponsorships as well for golfers.
There are a lot of little leagues happening around. We started with the IPL, at least now the football leagues come up, and golf, why not? I think that the way this started is great. In fact, Shiv spoke to us a couple of months back when GPL was at its inception stages, and in fact he spoke to us, but it was quite unfortunate we couldn't help him then because it was the fag end of our year and our budget and so on and so forth. But yeah, going forward, why not? Because again, the format is great. We're getting some great talent from across the world, and these guys are still top 20 players across the world. So I guess that's a great boost for the sport going forward. And if we start inculcating, or if we start even getting the kids out there, I think the game will be very different today. And again, golf is not about spectator viewership, but you never know. It's India. Anything which happens, when you have stars around, you have a lot of people around.
So what would be the new chapter in your career?
The new chapter in my career would be to ensure that the dream which I think my founders have as far as Micromax is concerned gets to a very sound stage. And I'm hoping that should be done in the next 2 to 3 years. And retire before 45, I guess.
That's early.
Yeah, that's early, I know. But yeah, I know that's
the company
early.
Surely seems to be paying you really well for you to plan like that, to retire at 45.
Yeah, again, there are a lot of things the company will do in the near future, and that could ensure a healthy retirement as well. So why not capitalize on it and play golf? There's lots of golf happening.
All right, on that note, thank you so much for joining me today on Tea Time.
Thank you, Chetty.
Really a pleasure to have you on the show today.
Likewise, and it was great chatting up with you as well.
Thank you. On that note, we will wind up the show. I will see you next week again. Until then, may the sport be with you.